Thank you for keeping us company. And if you just tuned in, this is Y254 News Highlights Discussion Monday. We are looking at the question, should the president dissolve his cabinet? Because we have seen in the recent days leaders from across the political divide piling pressure on President Uhuru Kenyatta to dissolve his cabinet. This is in the wake of a storm of the allegations to assassinate Deputy President William Ruto. And this has been going on. Discussion Monday, we want to see, should the president do that? And with me in studio is Kariuki Ngunjiri. He's a political analyst. Good evening, sir.
Good evening to you, Hillary.
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Now, according to Member of Parliament Kainan, he says Kenyans have lost confidence in the current lot of cabinet secretaries. Is this true?
Okay, maybe what he should have stated is the number of cabinet secretaries that Kenyans have lost faith in. Mm-hmm. So that it doesn't have to be a blanket opinion whereby because you want to induct somebody in the perceived cabinet reshuffle, mm-hmm. then you come out to the media to claim that the cabinet in its entirety is not equal to the task.
All right.
For me, let us not get into this hype mm-hmm. Of piling pressure on the president that he should reshuffle his cabinet in its entirety.
All right.
Let us look at the performances of the individual cabinet secretaries. Mm-hmm. And if there is that one who is underperforming, let him or her face the sacking if at all he or she is not ready to change, and chances prove that even if given a second chance, they will not be able to deliver. And remember, what is curtailing the Uhuru Kenyatta administration mm-hmm. is an in-house problem. It is not a problem that is emanating from the cabinet secretaries. Mm-hmm. If they put the Jubilee Party in order, mm-hmm. then that is to say that the government's function would be in line mm-hmm. with the Big Four agenda mm-hmm. and what the Jubilee government promised its people. So mm-hmm. for me, I feel let us not condemn the whole cabinet.
All right.
Let us look at the performance of individual cabinet secretaries.
All right. I wouldn't want to mention names here because it remains an allegation until proven to be true. But then we have the said cabinet secretaries.
Yes.
And in your own opinion, the whole bunch of cabinet secretaries, would you say they have performed the first term of President Uhuru Kenyatta and this second one now? Do you think the people who have been there, actually majority, if not all, have remained in the cabinet? So do you think these people have performed to the standard expected?
That clearly remains at the discretion of the appointee, the appointing authority, mm-hmm. that is His Excellency Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. And if you have seen him, as per now, he's not as he used to be, maybe a few months ago before Rashid mm-hmm. Aichesa was sacked. Mm-hmm. Perhaps reading the mind of the president, I can be able to see that he's contented with his cabinet. Mm-hmm. He has not complained yet, mm-hmm. apart from the recent allegations that were meted on his cabinet secretaries, who then denied the claims mm-hmm. that were meted on them as well. I have not heard the president complain. And if there is a cabinet secretary who is not doing as he should be doing, mm-hmm. according to me, it is not we that are supposed to be compelling the president to sack them, but it will be evident that they are...
How about if the president was turning a blind eye on this?
I think the president is very focused mm-hmm. on delivering on his re-election bid. And as such, I would, and you have seen the president has been very serious with matters of delivery. He is not joking this time round. Mm-hmm. It is his second and final term. Mm-hmm. And he does not give a damn to anything that will jeopardize his legacy. Mm-hmm. And so, let us believe him. Let us give him the benefit of doubt, mm-hmm. because he has not yet come out to complain. Mm-hmm. What grounds would a cabinet secretary be sacked from office? Number one, incapacitation. That is, if the cabinet secretary cannot be able to, does not have the capacity
to do
the duty. And then maybe sound, if he or she is not of sound mind, if the cabinet secretary is not making wise decisions, the mental problem.
Corrupt.
Yes, there is now the issue of graft mm-hmm. allegations. Mm-hmm. Now, in such a case, I would expect the cabinet secretaries themselves, mm-hmm. in a case where they are mentioned in a scandal, mm-hmm. even before the president sacks them, mm-hmm. let them step aside and pave way for investigations, so that if at all they are not guilty, mm-hmm. they will be reinstated.
You just said it's your expectation, but we have seen this happen more often. Someone is mentioned, but they're still in office and they are saying they will not move. We have seen that happen. Yeah,
in such a case,
at what point do you think Kenya will get to
in such
a stage?
In yes. such a case, mm-hmm. we would be justified as the people who gave the president the mandate mm-hmm. to lead us as a people. Mm-hmm. So in such a case where we have a cabinet secretary who is in a scandal, mm-hmm. and in this case, a cabinet secretary whose all chances mm-hmm. links him or her to that very scandal, mm-hmm. then that person would better step aside as early as possible. Okay. However, we cannot underestimate the people's opinions and what the masses feel. Mm-hmm. Yes, they are justified to give their opinions in a matters of national discourse.
All right.
And we will not fault them for the same. Mm-hmm. But again, let us not get hyped up by this issue of sack, 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 sack. And it is a perception that is being peddled by even people who have interests. Some of them would want to have their communities represented in cabinet, mm-hmm. and represented more, because we have quite a good share of representation, even if it does not meet the constitutional threshold.
Actually, speaking of which, there has been a question of Deputy President bringing the wrangles between the two sides, those people who are loyal to the president and those who are said to be affiliated or aligning with the Deputy President. Now, who is to blame between this part?
The problems that you are seeing right now have neither emanated from the Deputy President mm-hmm. nor the President. They have emanated from the people who claim to be the mouthpieces mm-hmm. of the two.
All right.
This is the Kieleweke team and the Tanga Tanga team, which is the genesis of all these problems. Mm-hmm. And it is docks on the doorstep of the president and his deputy as the two principals in the Jubilee Party to call their house in order and solve their in-house problems. Mm-hmm. And I expect a complete overhaul in the whole Jubilee Party discourse. We have, even you have seen members of the Jubilee Party asking for parliamentary group meetings. Mm-hmm. A parliamentary group meeting is necessary and is inevitable if at all mm-hmm. the Jubilee government seeks to propel this country to the next level and as well deliver on the Big Four agenda. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, so a member of parliament, Caleb Kositani, thinks the president is wrong on his silence following the allegations of assassination of deputy president. Now, what's your point? What's your take in this? What should the president say? What should he do? Because we have the DCI doing their mandate.
Okay, you see, we have not yet had the deputy president talking of the same. Mm-hmm. Equally, we cannot expect the president, who in such a case is a second party, mm-hmm. the deputy president is the first party, has not made a public complaint mm-hmm. on the same. So it becomes very tricky for the president to state his opinion or otherwise in such a case where investigative agencies are going through the whole process, and the whole thing of how would it appear if the president was to side with either, whether on the negativity of the allegations or the positivity mm-hmm. of the allegations. So I think from where I sit, the president has had the wisdom of Solomon mm-hmm. and he has been able to at least sit at the back and wait for the investigative agencies to do their job.
All right. As a nation, with the said allegations, where do we stand politically and even economically with such allegations?
With such allegations, I think that this brings a problem in the whole cabinet, because the deputy president is a member of the cabinet, and the people who are being indicted are in the very same cabinet. So that one tells you that in a way, even if they would shelve their personal problems during cabinet meetings and as follows in their functions, then we cannot run away from the fact that there will be a little bit of enmity. Mm-hmm. But again, in such a case, a wisdom of the moment is that let them declare mm-hmm. that, yes, we might have some ideological differences, but at least we are in the cabinet and serving the Kenyan people. Mm-hmm. So we have to do what is supposed to be done at this moment,
right,
regardless of what you feel, whether you would support me for president or you'll never support me for president. Mm-hmm. The people of Kenya are the ones who mm-hmm. hurt each time there is a tangle in the cabinet. Mm-hmm. And this owes to why they gave President Uhuru Kenyatta a mandate of another 5 years to also constitute a government, which now is rushing against time to deliver on the Big Four agenda. So I think it is for those cabinet members to shelve their personal differences and focus in helping the president to deliver on his Big Four agenda. So that one now shifts mm-hmm. to how the economy will fare going forward.
All right.
It will mean that even if there are differences in the cabinet, they will be driven by one mantra, that is service to the people of Kenya, and that is what is very important for them, at least at this moment.
All right, as we wind up, in as much as serious as the matter is, because having a plot or allegations to murder the deputy president, he's one person who is interested in the presidency come 2022 campaigns, and he wants to be there. Yeah. Now, do you think, because some people are saying it's seeking sympathy, in your own opinion, as yes. we wind up actually?
Okay, you see, in politics, we have such complexity whereby it is perception that works. Mm-hmm. Facts never works. Mm-hmm. So whenever there is a perception that has come out that, for example, there are people who are playing foul on me, mm-hmm. and as such, the people should feel sorry for me. Mm-hmm. And to interpret it from different angles, it depends from which camp perhaps one is from, because a person who is from the deputy president's side mm-hmm. would say that, look, why do you want to stop the deputy president from becoming president? That means he has already won the confidence of the people. Then on the other side, you have people from maybe the Kieleweke or the NASA side mm-hmm. would say that, look, the deputy president just wants to get sympathy. So it becomes a little bit complex, mm-hmm. and unless the investigative agencies get to the bottom of this, right. we cannot be able to establish or even perceive the truth as to this. As I finish, because yes, I understand yeah. that time is running against us,
right.
there is a certain issue that has arisen. And I had several youths complaining that the people who are being considered for the census jobs will not be ordinarily the majority unemployed young Kenyans who have degrees and diplomas. So I ask myself, as a young guy, why would this state, or why would this state of the nation be at this time when we are talking of a very high rate of unemployment among the young people? That is what a guy by the name Muriuki, watching us in a hotel in Muranga, Genda Ward, Itaga, would tell me, that look, we need people and leaders who would at any given time, even if you woke them up at 4 a.m. in the morning, the people of Kenya would be at their pulse. So for me, I think that it is time our leaders focused on the people's driven problems.
All right.
If a certain citizen has an opinion as regards to a certain policy, let them be heard, and let the government and the people in leadership apply curative measures to that problem.
All right.
So as we finish today, I know it is there is a game that is coming up.
Actually, it is ongoing. Mali.
Yes.
It's playing. So we'll get in.
So after here, I don't think
you will find the first half.
No,
the second half actually.
I bet I will because I will be traffic and issues. I will get perhaps the Ghana game.
Yeah, versus Tunisia.
I'm a Ghana fan.
All right, watch the Ghana versus Tunisia. All right, many thanks for coming. Just 1 minute, my director.
Yes.
Yes or no? Should the president dissolve his cabinet?
No, he should not.
All right. Many thanks for keeping us company. This is Y254 Discussion Monday. I have been speaking to Ngojuri Kariuki. He's a political analyst. And coming up next is Y Mashariki. Keep it Y254. I'll see you again on Monday. Have yourself a very good night. My name is Dereva Hilary.